Let's play! Niramekko!
Whoever laughs first loses.
Niramekko shimasho! Warau to make yo! Ah, boo boo!
Opera?
Yumi!
Hope you brought your sunscreen, Ami, because you're about to get burned.
Burned?
More like lightly toasted. Not bad, if you have no intention of winning. Okay, time to break out the big gun. Great. Hi-ya!
Yumi, are you okay?
She's more than okay. She's brilliant. In fact, I can't remember the last time I heard such a painfully perfect shriek.
Madame, what are you doing on my turf?
You two know each other?
You might say that, considering that I, Madame Blubbery, raised Yumi from infancy to be a classical opera singer. Even as an infant, she already had the makings of a diva. As she grew bigger, so did her talent. She was only days away from hitting a Z sharp over high C, the highest note known to man, when she had a temper tantrum and quit. Haven't found anyone as talented or as rebellious since.
I don't know what's more unbelievable, you singing opera or you wearing a tiara.
They're both freaky, which is why I bolted to become a rock star.
Well, you've wasted too much time on silly rock and roll. You must come with me and scream the lead in my new show.
Whoa, pause off, lady. There's no way I'm going anywhere with you.
We'll see about that.
Please, like that's gonna work on me now?
What is that thing?
Some goofy dog whistle the old bat used to use to control her students. Well, you can forget it, Blubbery. Those days are long gone. Nobody owns me now.
Yes, madame. We must train.
Welcome to your new home. Before you rejoin the world of opera, we must first cleanse the rock from your system.
Yes, madame.
Rock bad, opera good. 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 Rock bad, opera good.
I've missed you too, Ami. Kaz, would you like some tea?
Sure, I'd love some.
And how about some cake too?
Okay, why not?
Are you okay? Where's your angry scowl and scathing sarcasm?
I am very happy. Opera is my life.
I don't know what that blubber lady did to you, but you've got to snap out of it. Remember this girl? The smell of your lucky backstage sweat rag should bring you around. You can't tell me you've forgotten about this. It's worse than I thought.
Well, I must get back to my opera drills. It was so nice to see you both.
Kaz, did you see that? That's not our Yumi-chan.
Actually, I kind of like the new Yumi. She's a lot nicer to me.
We're not going to be able to see from way up here.
What's to see? It's an opera. I'll be asleep in a couple of
puppet, sing as you've never sung before.
Can you hear?
Louder, higher!
He shall live in song.
Louder! Don't stop until you hit the Z sharp of the high C.
Your opera bot. I'm a rocker.
What you are is a two-time quitter.
I never quit opera, Blubbery. I quit you. Time to turn this opera into a J-popera. Now that's the Yumi I know and love.
What? Is it over? Did our team win?
Oh, boy!
A cartoon!
Save the farm!
Wake up, Kaz. We're almost there.
What? Almost where?
Our favorite down-home country pit stop.
The old Happy Acres Farm.
Last time we were there, the farmer accidentally confused you with one of his cows, remember?
Ah, yes, yes. Who knew hay was so tasty, hmm?
Oh, I can't wait to see the farm again. It's gonna be so pretty and peaceful and green and...
Yucky? The Happy Acres don't look so happy these days.
Just sign on the dotted line and all your troubles will be over.
Well, okay then.
Farmer Zeke! What happened to your farm?
And who's the dude with the dead gerbil on his head?
I'm mighty sorry, Puffy Girls. This here city feller's about to buy my farm.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to turn this useless farmland into a giant parking Googleplex. In a few weeks, it'll be cars and concrete as far as the eye can see.
You can't do that. What about the piggies? What about the moo cows? What about Zeke?
Relax, little lady. They can all work for me. Building the parking lot.
You mean you've swindled a kindly old man out of everything he owns just to make a buck? Wah! Sugoi! I think I love you!
Chotto matta!
Yeah, Zeke. You don't really want to sell your farm, do you?
Of course I don't. But I got no choice. The chickens ain't laying like they used to. The cows ain't a-milking like they used to, and the goats ain't making fudge the way they used to.
Oh, well, back to the bus.
Kaz, what are you doing?
What? He's going out of business. And you never know when you're going to need a milking machine.
No, she means, what are you doing leaving? Zeke is our friend. He needs our help to save Happy Acres.
A couple of pop princesses are going to work this farm. That's rich. I'll believe that when I see it.
Who are you calling princess?
I'll be back tomorrow, old man. And you'd better be ready to sign.
Yeah.
Let's see what we got here. A half dozen crackety eggs, milk would taste like a girly shoe, and a bale of hay with a little feller in it.
Don't worry. I think I can eat my way out.
So, is this enough to save Happy Acres?
I wish it was, dearie. I wish it was.
Face it, we're lousy farmers.
No! We just need to work harder. We'll get up even earlier tomorrow.
Sorry, Princess, but there's not going to be a tomorrow. It's now or never, old man. Sell your farm to me tonight, or lose it to the bank in the morning.
I guess I just can't win.
Wait, I think I know how to save Happy Acres. We may be lousy farmers, but we're pretty good at something else.
Hello, Happy Acres!
Rokishose!
Well, Puffy girls, you done saved my farm. Thank you kindly.
Ah, 私の豚ちゃん。
4 pounds of fudge! Bumba, yeah!
And I know how much you like that there milking machine, little feller, so I'm a gonna let you keep it.
どうもありがとう。 Thank you. Get it off me! Help!
So, anyway, I bet I can eat more fudge than your pig can.
You're on!
Okay, Jonkin, let's try it again. And this time, let's pick up the tempo a little.
It's here! It's here! It's here! My latest letter from Pierre has arrived!
What's a Pierre?
My pen pal from Paris! I can always tell his letters because they're covered in his special mystery scent.
Sacre bleu!
Yes, it is nice. Did I mention Pierre's a poet? Listen to this. Laughing, dancing, prancing, you are my pretty pony. Just the thought of you by my side makes me quiver like macaroni. Pretty romantic, huh?
Yeah, nothing like a pasta poem to tug at the old heartstrings.
I don't believe it! He's coming to visit! Today! I'm finally gonna meet the man of my dreams! Pierre-sama!
expecting maybe a Burt Reynolds?
Oh, eh? What happened?
How should I know? I just came out to see what all the commotion was about.
Oh my gosh, it's him! Oh, Pierre, what a pleasure to finally meet... you?
Pleasure to meet you too, pen pal!
But your muscles, your hair, your accent, I thought you were from Paris.
I am from Paris. Paris, Idaho, to be precise. Hey, look, I brought you a present from home.
This has to be some kind of mistake. What about the letters? The special mystery scent?
Scent? Oh, you must mean the bronchial ointment I rub on my chest. That stuff gets on everything.
Wow, Pierre. It was so great of you to come. But, here's the thing. I've got this really strict manager who, never lets me go anywhere.
I don't care what you do as long as it costs me nothing.
This is gonna be great. Get ready for some major excitement, Abby.
Well, this is your idea of major excitement? The library?
Oh, yes. I donate my spare time reshelving books. I find touching knowledge exhilarating.
Wouldn't it be more fun if we...
Please whisper. Library rules. Abby, I'm afraid you can only check out 3 books per visit.
Put them on my card.
Shh.
Ooh, what is this place?
The Museum of Natural History Entomology Exhibit. This is the new flying stink beetle collection I wanted to share with you. They're mixing your lovely locks with their saliva to create a duplex nesting site for their young. Oh, isn't that sweet?
Now this is more likely. So what do we do first? Super dance attack? Stink beetle smackdown?
Don't be absurd. There is only one true video game challenge for me. Video chess. Hello, Abby.
Pierre, wait!
Thank you. You have credit for 450 matches.
Your move.
Yeah!
Wow, what a magical day. The library, the insect exhibit, my 450 wins at chess. It was so special. But I still haven't shown you what I can do with my inhaler and an empty fruit cup.
Listen, Pierre. I really appreciate everything, but I have to be honest with you. I don't think you and me...
Oh, I almost forgot. I wrote a new poem I want to read to you.
Pierre, no.
Your face is like a flower whose petals I long to hold. I want to shelter you in my arms so that together we may grow old. So, what do you think?
Oh, Pierre, that was beautiful.
Gee, thanks. Say, are you okay? You look kind of sick or something.
You know, Pierre, you may not be exactly what I expected, but perhaps you wouldn't make such a bad boyfriend after all.
Boyfriend? What are you saying? Jeez, I thought we were just pals, pen pals.
But the poem.
What, this? I just wanted your opinion. I wrote it for Yumi. I've been thinking about her all day. Now I can share it with my one true love. Oh, Yumi, are you there? I've got a surprise for you!
Stand back! I mean it! You better stay away from me, you little weirdo!
I love it when a chick plays hard to get.
Oh, well. Anybody out there need a pen pal?
Pickle.